Well, look at there. You have changed the lick.
How are you?
I'm doing great.
I thought I'd just bring him by the place and show him.
All right.
I walk a crooked road to get where I'm going, to get where I'm going. I must walk a crooked road, and only when I'm looking back I see the straight and narrow. I see the straight and narrow when I walk a crooked road. I sing a lonesome song to anyone who listen, to anyone who listen. I will sing a lonesome song. And when I hear you singing too, the sorrow sounds hopeful. The sorrow sounds so hopeful when I sing my lonesome song. And a lonesome song will be my true companion when all else has abandoned for singing of their own. And a lonesome song will fill my days with gladness, make joy out of sadness when I sing my lonesome song. I love with all my heart. There is no way of stopping. I have no way of stopping. I just love with all my heart. Through the broken and the beautiful, the bad news and the good news, the bad news and the good news is I love with all my heart. And a loving heart will be my true companion when all else has abandoned for loving of their own. And a loving heart will fill my days with gladness, make joy out of sadness when I bring this loving heart to you.
Up in the Appalachian area, coal mining areas of Virginia and Kentucky, it's easy to see that when the coal mines have gone out of business, that people are left with no incomes. But in our community, the same thing has happened because people lived here on predominantly very small areas of land that they tried to farm. And when farming became unprofitable, the majority of jobs in our community dried up too. So people are still left with a place that they can live in, on a small farm, but there's no money to live on. So those folks now that have retired and they exist on a $500 a month Social Security check, when the roof starts leaking, what happens? You let your roof leak. Or if the car breaks down, you let your car stay broken down. You learn to live with or cope with the situation that you're in. And over a period of years, some of those situations are terrible.
One day for to hear them shout and pray, all to hear preaching cloud a gospel cloud. Hold on, hold on, keep your hand on the plow and hold right on. The preacher said I must repent, so right down the aisle I went. Keep your hand on the plow and hold right on. Your hand on the plow and you'll ride on.
been to heaven, and I've been told it's a first class city and the streets are good. You keep your head on the plow and you hold right on. Hold on, hold on. Keep your head on the plow and you hold right on. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, all them prophets is dead and gone. Keep your head on the plow and you hold right on. Hold on, hold on. Keep your head on the plow and you hold right on.
Born and raised in Tennessee?
Yes, I was born and raised in Tennessee. Okay.
What would you describe your life as, like, right now?
Well, not really satisfied, troubled, and what?
I also had a lot of fun talking to Ms. Carolyn and Boo and Ms. Jennifer. They really made an impact on me on just how much they love each other and just they get through things as sisters, and they just love each other more than anything on this earth, and it's very clear.
Yeah, it seemed like I'm looking for something and I can't find it.
So I had a lot of fun working on Ms. Carolyn's house. I got to lay down this ugly green carpet, but now it's beautiful because it's like fits perfectly. Before it did not fit. Tell me about your life, like your childhood. What was it like?
Well, my childhood growing up, it was good.
Yeah, both of your parents there and everything?
Yeah, my parents was there. Well, now it's just my mom and my daddy's gone. Yeah.
What's your favorite color?
Yeah. Pink.
Pink, like your hair? I like it. Do you have any children?
I got one. That's my son. That's who's got this ring.
Nice.
How do you feel about us doing all of this?
I love it. I thought something like that would never happen to me.
Oh.
Really, I did. I'm
happy. Thank you.
Blessing us more than you know, so.
Well, it's a blessing more than you know, trying to help, because I couldn't do it on my own. Yes.
We take so much for granted in life. Like, we just don't even think about how blessed we are, and there's people out here in this world that are just so, they don't have as much as we do, but yet they have so much joy in their life.
I've had a whole lot, and I appreciate yous a lot. Yous don't know how much.
Gratitude in my heart. And I used to always think that you had to go out of the country to go on a mission trip, like, that's what you need to do, but there's so much need just in here in America and in our backyard. There's need everywhere for us to go.
I got cancer, you can see right there. Yeah, it's good. It come back.
In your spine.
And it's in my spine. Mm-hmm. And I got COPD. Yeah. And I got a lot of stroke. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
about a year. It's not been not hardly a year ago. I lost my husband. My sister, she lives down there along the hill.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, pretty much straight up a hill. She carried water up here for me to drink and flush my commode, take a bath. I sit some rights and read the Bible.
Mm-hmm. I will bring a praise. No weapon formed against me shall be made. I will rejoice. I will declare.
I call on him all the time. I say my prayers every night. Yeah, I do that. I do one for him. I don't think I can make it. He's my friend. He's there when I need him. He's there.
I am a conquering co-heir with Christ. So firm on his promise I stand. And that will bring a praise. I will bring a pain, no weapon formed against me shall be made. I will rejoice, I will declare, God is my victory and he is here. All of my life, in every season, you are still kind, I have a reason to sing. I have a reason to worship. All of my life, in every season, you are still God. I have a reason to sing. I have a reason to worship. And I will bring a praise. I will bring a praise. No weapon formed against me shall be.
As Christians, we are servants at heart. God has called us to serve. With love in our hearts, guided by the Holy Spirit, and a passion for the hope that can only be found in Jesus Christ, we serve. Mission work can be in our own neighborhood. It can be in our own home. Mission work can be in our own town, in our own county, in our own state. So why should a group of people like Christian Dominion School travel to Northeast Tennessee to do mission work? Because here on a mission trip to do mission work, we can serve and get a whole new perspective on things that we become callous to and used to every day of our lives. Here we can see people living in a different geographical area with some slightly different customs, with a slightly different heritage. We become more aware of our surroundings and more aware of the people. By leaving the comfort of our own element, we grow as believers. But no mission trip is complete without gathering together to worship, whether it's in our daily devotions or our Sunday service. No mission trip is complete without laughter and good times. Hard work together serving a cause like Jesus, laughter, having good times together, learning new things and being a part of new experiences together is relationship, and that relationship built around Jesus Christ helps the church grow, and each one of us are the church. Dominion Christian Schools traveled to Northeast Tennessee and partnered with the One Accord Ministry to serve those in need in the Appalachia region, in Hawkins and Hancock counties. Some of the poorest of the poor in this entire country live in this area. While here on our trip in 2016, we got to stop at a place to have lunch at the River Place, float down the river on inner tubes, laughing and carrying on. We got to go on a hayride courtesy of a local church, and some of the people are brothers and sisters who are also in love with Jesus. We got to experience Appalachia culture.
Jesus paid it all, all to him I go. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed you white as snow.
We come to be a blessing to people, but you will come away far more blessed than you were when you thought you were going to come. It's a lot of fun. There are some tears that will be shed, but they're good spiritual tears. It's a lot of hard work, but it's worth everything. It's worth everything to come and experience the joy of watching kids work together, watching adults work together, and everybody work for a common purpose. And that's to further God's kingdom.
Exciting thing to see potentially the students who are on this trip being transformed. We realize that students, the effort they put into preparing for these trips will result in the amount of blessing they get from it. And we always challenge them and encourage them that if they make that preparation and they do it diligently and sincerely, it will pay off in their experience. And this has been one of my favorite of groups of young people to have the privilege of leading. They're just a very positive and well-behaved and group, and they are working hard, and they are just being very respectful, and yet they're very willing to share and very willing to be open and transparent with their feelings. And of course, the goal of all our mission trips is that when the students return, they will be different. Just most every mission trip I've ever heard of, whether it's ours or someone else, that's the goal. But once again, that's our heart. We want them to impact wherever they go, whether it's helping them in a physical way, their environment. But we prefer to not only do that, but have the individuals they minister to, their hearts be changed and their hearts be drawn to Jesus Christ. And if possible, individuals coming into the kingdom of God and lives being challenged and put back together and encouraged by a group of young people coming through and giving up their time and their effort and their money to make a difference in the lives of some people who are very challenged and struggling greatly. So it's a joy each year to be involved in this and to lead this group, even though there's a lot of responsibilities. That's always greatly diminished compared to hanging out with the kids and the other leaders and just seeing Christ working in their hearts. So yes, it's been a wonderful journey, and I challenge you who are interested in going next year to our next field of service, that this type of trip and the places we go most often will help you appreciate where you live, what you have, and the opportunities you have, and has the potential to make you grateful people. Because if you're a grateful person, it will influence so many parts of your life. And if you don't know Jesus Christ personally, you will hear the gospel on this trip. And you will be given that opportunity to believe on Christ. And if you are limping along in your Christian life, and you're just, making it, and you know you're Christian, but it's kind of, you got used to it, and you're just kind of lukewarm, there's also the opportunity to grow and to get into your quiet time and really know Christ expressed in and through this ministry. So, it's a joy to have you. It's a blessing to me and other leaders and other students. We hope you consider coming along in the future.
I dreamed I went to heaven. You were there with me. We walked upon the streets of gold beside the crystal sea. We heard the angels singing. Then someone called your name. You turned and saw this young man. He was smiling as he came. And he said, "Friend, you may not know me now." Then he said, "But wait. You used to teach my Sunday school, and I was only 8. Every week you would say a prayer before the class would start. And one day when you said that prayer, I asked Jesus in my heart. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am the life that was changed. Then another man stood before you. He said, "Remember the time a missionary came to your church. His pictures made you cry. You didn't have much money, but you gave it anyway. Jesus took the gift you gave. That's why I'm here today. Changed. Thank you for giving to me."